In this video, I'm going to show you how we can make this simple and yet very beautiful mouse effect inside of Figma, in which wherever the user hovers a specific part of the element on the screen, we will have this blurry effect. So bear with me until the end of this video if you want to know how. My name is Kia, and here's a Kimo. Welcome to my channel. I have made and published a lot of videos about how we can track the mouse movement inside of Figma and then use the prototyping panel in order to build a specific interaction and in result have a mouse effect. If you haven't watched those videos, you can find the link to those videos inside the description of this one, or you can also click on the pop-up banner on top and watch those videos later on. And in this video, I'm going to use the same principle to build this mouse effect that I show you in the intro of this video. But before we go further, I would like to ask you to subscribe to my channel if you're new here, and if you haven't done yet, like this video and share this video with the other designers in your community. Plus, I have made a Discord server that you can join there, which we can be in contact closely, so you can share your questions and problems with me and I will try to help you with them. You can find the link to the Discord server in the description of this video as well, or you can scan the QR code on the screen. Now, without further ado, let's get started. So first of all, in order to be able to see the effect properly, I'm going to add one image into my design canvas. From the toolbar, I'm going to open the action menu and switch to the plugins and widget tab. There I'm going to search for the all stock plugin and then I'm going to open it. I usually use this plugin in order to add images into my design canvas if I'm not looking for any special footage. The reason is that it has a really good collection of the footages from different resources. For example, here in this case, I'm going to search for the image and then I'm going to scroll down until I find the image that I would like to have in my design file. Then I'm going to click on, for example, in this landscape image and then add it to my design. In the first step, I would like to create my effect, which is basically this squares with the blurry effect. So I'm going to pick up the frame tool and make one square frame. For now, I'm going to set the sizing of this frame to 32 pixel. Later on, this would be the size of the hitbox of my effect. However, right now it doesn't matter so much. We can use the scale tools in order to scale up or scale down this effect later on. In the next step, from the fill section in the design panel, I'm going to reduce the opacity of the background color of this frame to something close to zero, but not zero itself. And the reason is, if we set the opacity to 0% and we add background effect to it later on, such as the blur effect, we won't be able to see that effect because the opacity is zero. So we get close to zero, but not zero. Okay, let's scroll down in the design panel and find the effect section. Then I'm going to click on this plus button here and add my effect to the frame. The effect that I'm going to choose is going to be the background blur. So let's open up the drop-down menu here and switch to the background blur effect. We can open the setting of this effect by clicking on this icon next to the effect that we add. Here we can kind of decide which amount of blurriness we would like to have for this square. In this step, you can decide any amount that you would like to have for the blurriness of this block. The only point that you need to have in mind is that we're gonna duplicate this block in order to build the rest of the squares that we would like to have at the end for the final result, for the final design, which we have agreed after blocks. And the point is that the further we get from the center of this grid, the blurriness of the effect is going to be reduced. And at the end, when we get to the edge of this design, we would have no blurriness. In order to build this effect, we need to choose a specific amount for the block in the center that we can reduce it gradually that we get further from the center of the grid. For example, here I'm going to make a copy of this block and then position it on top of the first block that we made. Then I'm going to reduce the opacity of this block to something less than what we had before. And then I'm going to copy this one three more times and position one in the right side, one in the left side, and one below the first block that we had. Now the first block that we made is going to be the central block. So we need to build the rest of the grid with the same principle. At the end, you should have something like this one that I have here, a bunch of squares with the blur effect, which the blurriness is going to get reduced further we get from the center of the grid. In the next step, I'm going to use the combination key Control G to group all these blocks together. The reason that I'm not using frame and I'm using the group instead is that I would like to keep the position of the frames that I built as they are. I don't want to build a stack. If I use a frame, then I will build a stack, which I need to play around to build the same positioning, which I don't want to get into that. I'm going to select the group that we made right now and then use the combination key Shift A to make a new frame and add this group as a child layer to that frame and apply auto layout on the parent frame. Combination key Shift A is going to do all these things for me. And the reason that I need this frame is because I'm going to resize this frame to the size of the block that we have in the center. And I'm going to use it in order to build my interaction. So basically, this is going to be our hitbox. Before we resize this parent frame, I'm going to get sure that I set the alignment of this auto layout on the center. So in this case, if I start to resize the parent frame, the group that we build is going to stay in the center of the frame. I'm going to add another background image and try to move this box that we made around to see how the effect is working. I'm doing this step in order to see if I need to increase the blurriness or, for example, I should increase the opacity of the background color in order to build stronger effect. So do this before you finalize your work. In the next step, we're going to work on the interaction and build the final effect. So in order to be able to see this squares, I will add a stroke to this squares, the red one that you can see right now. So this will help me to kind of understand where my elements are. And then I'm going to select the frame that we built, the parent frame in the center, and convert it to a component. My interaction at the end of the day is going to be appearing and disappearing this component. So I will make one component with two variants. In order to make that, I'm going to select the frame that we converted to the component. And here in the design panel on top, I'm going to click on this plus icon, which is going to create a new variant for the same component and basically transform the component that we made to a component set. I'm going to use the first variant to build the default state in which we basically don't see the effect. The second variant is going to be for the state that the basically this blur effect is going to get appear. And the trigger of this interaction is going to be while hovering. So whenever the users basically hover a specific part of the screen, this way we can track the mouse movement. So let's select the first variant, the default state, and then reduce the opacity in the appearance section in the design panel to 0. And let's get rid of this red stroke that we built in order to kind of see the design better. Now let's switch to the prototype panel. We're gonna make our interaction. So I'm gonna select the first variant, the default state, and I'm going to connect this variant to the second variant, which is going to be our basically hover state. For the setting of our interaction, I'm going to set the trigger on while hovering, which makes sense because we would like this interaction happen whenever the user hover the hitbox that we have in the center. For the animation type, I'm going to set the animation type on a smart animation, which will help us to have a smooth transition between these two states. Now the main question is that how we can add the effect that we made into specific UI elements, such as this teaser that you can see. It's very simple. We need to make a frame and apply auto layout on that, and then copy one instance of the hitbox that we made into that, and then copy paste or duplicate that one as much as possible in order to have a kind of a frame which can cover our UI element, which is this teaser. In order to make the process easy, I'm going to set the basically stack orientation in the auto layout setting panel to wrap. In this case, I just need to copy paste the hitbox without caring about the size of the parent. They are going to basically fill the parent layer horizontally as much as there is a space. And if there is no space, they're gonna kind of go to the next row. Now that I have this frame with all the hitboxes in it, I just need to add this one to the any UI element that I would like to have this effect in it, such as this teaser. So I'm going to grab this one, copy paste it into the teaser. I'm gonna set the positioning of this frame to absolute positioning. In this case, I can just move this element or this frame around the teaser without caring about the auto layout. Basically, it's going to ignore the auto layout. You can scale up or scale down this overlay that we made with the hitboxes in order to cover whole area of our UI element. We can also scale it up or down for another reason. We can do this in order to kind of make this blur effect bigger by kind of scaling up our squares, or smaller by kind of scale it down. Now we can simply just run the prototype and see the effect and how it works. It might look not that smooth that we kind of expect, and the reason is that we have a lot of kind of instances of that component that we build with the interaction, and this kind of will reduce the performance, especially when you run it in the prototype mode. But in general, kind of, we can get the feelings of how this effect is going to work. So it's going to be ready for the development process. We can simply copy paste the teaser that we made and change the content, change the image, and the effect is going to be there because we already have it in all of them. Or we can just use the frame of all the hitboxes that we had in order to add it to another UI element, such as this teaser. So it's going to be very simple after this step to add this effect to any element that you would like to have in your design. So that was it for this video. I hope you learned something new and you enjoyed this video. If it was so, please don't forget to support me by liking this video and share it with the other designers in your community. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done yet. And at the end, one more time, don't forget to join to my Discord server where you can share your ideas for the next video. So let me know what exactly you want to see here in this channel. Let's learn together and see you in the next video.